not the way I wanted to start today's vlog. We're currently sitting on Friday morning, 8:30 a.m. in Belfast. So I'm down outside the back clinic in Dunmurry to see my boy Jonathan Sinclair, see if he can work a bit of magic. After he had the setback last Tuesday, I had suffered a little bit of a back injury and it was problematic for about 4 or 5 days. Let's just say activity levels were reduced to zero. But the last, this week, the first couple of days of the week, I've been feeling really, really good. And then, unfortunately, it flared up yesterday. So that's really taking things to a standstill almost. We're due to fly out this afternoon to Birmingham and then compete on Sunday. So I've only a couple of days. So I'm down with Johnny. I'm not really willing to have anything like from an adjustment standpoint, because you know you can get sort of a lot of referral from those, and residual issues can occur as well. So probably a little bit of ultrasound, something like that, nothing too aggressive, just enough to get me on that stage without me collapsing. So I'm in a lot of a fair level of discomfort, but hopefully after wee adjustment with my boy, I'll be feeling a lot better and ready to rock that stage on some level. So touch base with you guys soon. Just out of the adjustment with Jonathan Sinclair, and reasonably good news. He just reckons that it was quite badly over compartmentalized. The injury last week, even though it had been feeling a little bit better for a few days there, he reckons the soft tissue will still be in a recovery state, and maybe have moved a certain way and the body hasn't liked it, so it's locked it down. And with that over compartmentalization, the vertebral column has been compressed, so that's created a little bit of pressure. There was referral into the likes of my testicle, like sharp pains. That can happen once you have, I think it's L3, L4 in around them vertebrae. I can refer that way. My mobility was just really restricted as well, so we did a little bit of light manipulation work, tested out the things like the SI joint. Everything was fine there. There was nothing that needed adjusted, and he was fairly happy. Gave me a few sort of decompression movements and drills to do today over the next few days to get me ready for the stage on Sunday. So 2 days out, I'm still optimistic. I feel a lot better immediately after that treatment, but as long as I stay active today and don't allow it to seize up, I'm pretty confident that I should be okay. So let's keep it. I'll touch base with you guys very soon.
And like clockwork, the missus has added the last banner of the season. So good luck, James, on your PCA Pro debut. One last dance to finish an epic season. Go kill it with the date. Balloons. And then it's time for Maltesers and red wine. So these are the things. The final countdown. Nice red. And then there's a Rapasso and an Amarone Del Valpacello, which is a beautiful wine as well, and then a lovely little card again. So that's the last time that I'll have this sort of pre-show ritual of Vidal treat me to the luxuries and the good stuff. So definitely, as long as my old body holds up, I am fired up and ready to rock. So we're probably going to go for a bit of a coffee here. We'll be heading up to the airport to be at the drop the car off at about 1 o'clock. Flights 3:30, something like that, 3:45, and then I'm just going to get a taxi from the airport to the hotel. Simple reason, with my back, I don't want to take risks dragging all the suitcases with all the food and all that stuff around, so we'll just be in a taxi, and I don't care if it costs a hunno. I just got to protect the old man back at this point, and then once we get over there, I'll just be moving domestically and doing as little as possible until the show day. So we'll probably touch base with you once we get over to Birmingham, and hopefully you guys are having a great day.
And just like that, we are in the Adagio apartments in Birmingham. So you need to be selecting a place that has a kitchen. So we delve straight in there, getting that work done. I am having a decaf.
just had a meal, and other than that, I have two more meals before sleep, and then tomorrow will be Saturday, so it'll be a full day, and then competing on Sunday. So I'm looking forward to it. Tomorrow's plan will just be walking around, maybe treat ourselves to a nice coffee, check out the market, which is pretty busy, hustle and bustle, and then the rugby is on tomorrow evening. So there she is. Ireland, Australia, England, New Zealand. So that'll keep me entertained in the evening, tomorrow evening. Tomorrow, I'll have a wee bit of online work to get done this evening, and then I'll get most of the rest of it finished tomorrow. And then it'll be reallocation then on Sunday morning for all the team. So Sunday then I'll just be business. It'll be competition and hopefully the back holds out. So far after the treatment this morning with Johnny and the flight, you're sitting around, you don't really know, you're quite tight naturally anyway. So just need to try and get a wee bit more movement throughout the remaining part of this evening. Just sort of assess how the back's actually feeling. I haven't been able to practice posing all week really, because I knew that would have aggravated it more. So that's always a little bit of a risk as well. If I feel up to it tomorrow, I'll put a few rounds in. I won't be too aggressive with it, try and hold back as much as I can. So I'm as fresh as possible going into Sunday's show. So I'll keep you updated throughout the course of the weekend. Keep it real. There she is, in her happy place. Morning at the show. Second coat on, and we're getting ready to go. So we're gonna go over to watch the first block of competitors, which will kick off at 11. It's just around 11 o'clock now. So we're gonna get together, down there across, 10 minute walk to the venue, and watch the first block. So first block will be, I think Daz Cooper, a good friend of mine, will be on around sort of 5th or 6th, so I'm hoping in around sort of 12:30, and he'll be in the Masters over 50s, and he will be dangerous. He is just a phenomenal athlete and a very, very good friend. So Daz had a tough year, but a very successful competitive year, so I'd just like to see him get what he deserves today. So, and I'm sure he will. Other than that, then my registration, athlete registration, will be for block two, which I'll be going over there for about 1:30, get registered, get my team PCA UK or British jacket, and then I'll be ready to come back. We're going to come back probably later in this afternoon to just chill out at the hotel for a little bit, and then we'll go back over probably around sort of 4:30, 4:00. And get ready for me going on. So as I said, around sort of 6 o'clock, 6:30, I should be on stage. Hopefully done and dusted by 7:00. And then that'll be the conclusion of a astronomical season of bodybuilding for me personally, and obviously Edel as well. So hopefully you guys are enjoying the content so far, and we'll be inserting some footage as well from the actual show itself.
Hit the legs, Daz!
Side, chest, dirty side.
Come on, Jarvis!
Your new PCA World Champion and an over 50s Masters Bodybuilding class representing Team GB.
Yo, we are back at the hotel. It's in between, it was the break. So it kicked off at 11 this morning. Then they had a break from 3 p.m. to 3:30. So it is now just after 3:30 and the show has started back up again. So we're actually watching it on the live stream on the laptop, just to sort of see what categories and how quickly that they're moving. We are going to move across, try and get a decent seat in the venue. And so update on the my category, which is going to be the PCA Pro Classic Bodybuilding. And it's just going to be an open class. So there's no height. PCA don't do a height to weight restriction anyway, but there's no height restriction. It's just going to be an open class. So just see if the wee man can sort of hold his own on that stage again. And I really want to enjoy it. You know, I've been really hesitant the last couple of days just with the back discomfort as well. And on that, I had to modify my posing routine because a few of the shots in the routine were definitely going to aggravate that area. So I decided to try and move them out and change a few things and stuff. So literally, I was putting that together today. I haven't been able to pose all week because I knew that if I pose, it's just going to overcompartmentalize a lot of that muscle. And as a result, I'm not going to be able to move on stage if I could get on stage. So at least I'm fairly confident at this point that I will get on stage. How I'm going to be able to hit the poses, I'm not sure, because I honestly haven't practiced them really the last sort of three, four days at least, maybe a few days more than that. Hopefully the conditioning from the other shows that I've done this year will carry me over on stage. And it's for me right now, I just want to need to visualize that first pose with the front relaxed, hit it as hard as I can, and then just hopefully ease into the show. So we'll keep you updated on the proceedings as we move forward. I should be on stage in around 2 hours time, maybe just shy of 2 hours, we'll see. So and then out for a burger and a couple of glasses of vino. So we'll catch up with you guys in a little bit.
Gentlemen facing the rear, back double biceps.
Come on, James, get the hips back. Yep. Nice. Yes.
Relax one.
Yep.
Gentlemen turning to face the front, abdominals and calf.
Come on, James, this is your pose. Hard, yes. Let's see the vacuum. Yes, nice.
Most muscular.
Go on, Jim.
Any classical shots of your choice. And relax. Thank you, competitor.
Maybe the lessons that I've seen.
James.
This may be the last night that I'm breathing.
Come on, James.
I heard that pictures don't change, just the people inside of them do. Whoever told you that life would be easy, I promise that person was lying.
Yeah.
Beautiful, beautiful restaurant. But it ain't going to get classy around here. We're going to smash some burgers and fancy ass wine. Yeah, yeah. Just going to do a little finish to the vlog, and I'm going to just summarize how the weekend actually went, and which was the PCA World Championships, which was my PCA Classic Bodybuilding Pro debut. It is now Wednesday, so Adele and myself arrived back home late last night, and obviously the show was on Sunday, so I've had a couple of days to kind of process it and review some of the sort of footage and photos that, you know, some kind people were able to send me through as well. So at the time I was really sort of disheartened. I didn't really enjoy my time on stage because of the discomfort that I was in and how the back, and I felt that it sort of affected how I posed and maybe how I performed. It probably didn't look like I was enjoying it as much as I normally do. Other than that, obviously because I felt that there was a little bit of degradation with my condition as a result of the stress that the body was under with the injury, But with my own eyes, then it was magnified. I was like, I was looking at myself like it was worse than it was. And it wasn't until I watched the footage back, and Dale was like, you've got to watch this back, you know, you looked incredible and blah, blah, blah. Obviously, she's a little bit biased for obvious reasons, but once I watched the footage back, I couldn't watch it the night of the show. I was like, no, I'm not in the right headspace to watch this. We'll see to it tomorrow. And I watched it the next day, and I was like, pleasantly surprised. I felt like I actually looked a lot better than I had visualized in my own head. So for that, I'm really, really happy, and I'm fairly grateful. And you know, obviously I want to finish the season off. That I had no aspirations as to where I was going to place going into the show. But what I wanted was to finish off the season with a bang, you know, make sure that my condition was on point, my fullness and all those things. And I felt like I wasn't able to deliver that. So I think I was probably, if you could put a numerical value on it, I was maybe 5-10% below par, below my absolute peak of condition. So, you know, it's the nature of the beast. We end up focusing on the negatives all too often, and I think that I need to get my head into a good space where I'm focusing on the positives of not just the weekend, but the season in its entirety. And I have had a few days to sort of try and get my head around it, and I'm actually really happy with how the actual weekend went. It was a pro debut for PCA, and I was able to dust that off. I can now go into a recovery phase to make sure that I can get the back fixed, make sure that, you know, my sort of hormone levels are back in a good spot, and then focus on the next developmental phase. And I'm really excited about that project as well. So, you know, that's all going to be, you know, putting everything together to bring me back onto the stage again, an improved version of what I brought this season. So I'm highly motivated and honestly can't wait just for the next sort of phase of this journey. So I obviously want to thank Ideal again. She literally just was like a one-man team and just pushed me through the weekend once again. And as long as she says that she was proud, then I'm happy. You know, and obviously then the feedback that I've gotten, the private messages that I've had from people that were even at the show, a lot of people that have seen some of the sort of social media content as well. So that's been massively supportive, and I've taken a lot of positives away from that as well. So I'm just going to draw a line there and say I'm actually happy with what happened at the weekend. I'm happy with placing fourth in that lineup. And I'm reasonably happy with the product that I brought to the stage as well. So I am going to keep the vlogs coming and some sort of different training footage. I'm going to be collaborating with some guys that are going to come across the compound room and train with me over the next sort of 4 or 5 months. So we'll make sure to try and document that and still push out some content. So to everybody that supported and liked and subscribed, commented, you know, thank you very much, honestly, from the bottom of my heart. This has been a very good season for me, and it's been nice to be able to document that through using the vlogs as well. So look, just thank you very much, everybody. Keep being positive, surround yourself with good people. If you have ambition of any description, whether it's through business or through training or aesthetically, or you want to compete at some point, just make sure that the people that you have around you understand what you want to do, why you want to do it. Make sure they're there for the right reasons. If somebody isn't adding positivity, then they're not adding anything, guys. So I'm quite fortunate to have like just a handful of really good people that have helped just be really supportive throughout the course of this season. And that, trust me, that's made it so, so much easier as well. So once again, thank you very much, and I'm out.